Hello, internets. Duke of the Bump here. And this is an apology stream, since I did not stream on Thursday. Hopefully I can go a little bit longer than the normal couple of hours to make up for the tardiness. I do apologize sincerely and profusely. But shit happens, you know? Sometimes you get the bear, and sometimes the bear gets you. And on Thursday, it got me good. And it looks like CPC Gamer is the only one in the chat room right now, but that's okay, since this is sort of an impromptu, you know, surprise stream. So last time, I beat the cathedral with Kane, and I got the second piece of the puzzle up in the top right-hand corner there. And I've been playing a little bit in my own time, since the only character I haven't beaten Sheol with at this point is Samson. I've been trying to go through the game as Samson, and it's pretty difficult. Samson is not a great character when you first start out. I mean, he has the Bloodlust, which is awesome, but stat-wise, he's probably the worst character in the game. He starts with one heart, one soul heart, and his starting damage is not that great, you know, until he starts killing some stuff and he gets the effect of the Bloodlust. And his starting shot speed is just a joke. So, I mean, late in the game, you know, he's a better character because, you know, he has the Bloodlust the whole time, but starting out, it's pretty rough. But that's not what I'll be doing today. Today, I will be tackling some of the challenges. I've done the first challenge, Dark with the Night. That one was pretty easy. All that one does is it makes you have the Curse of Darkness the entire time you're playing. So basically, you can't see the map at all. Welcome, just drop to the chat room. First time I've seen you in the stream in a while, which, you know, I'm sure there are reasons. But welcome. And if anyone else is in the chat room and I haven't said hey, you know, just say something because Twitch might be acting weird. Because CPC Gamer said something, but he's not showing up in the actual list of people, so Twitch is a bitch. Sorry to be so blunt, but there you go. So yeah, I'll be trying some of these other challenges. Now, when I beat Dark with the Night, for some reason, I think you're supposed to unlock the candle when you beat that one. The Java chat is messed up. Can you see this? Yeah. The chat room on the website isn't working? That is really unfortunate if that's the case. Wow, okay. Well, if you have an IRC client, just connect to... hold on. Connect to dukeofthebump.jtvirc.com. That's like dukeofthebump.jtv, as in Justin TV, irc.com. And then join the channel, #dukeofthebump. Wow, this is going to be a boring stream if, like, nobody's going to be in the chat room. But at least I have CPC Gamer and Just Drop, so... that's better than nothing, I guess. But like I was saying, you're supposed to unlock the candle when you complete the challenge. But for some reason, I got whatever you get from unlocking challenge number 2. So I'm not sure if it's just backwards and I'll unlock the candle when I do this one, or what's going on. I don't know if it's a common problem or anything. But I don't know what's involved in any of these other challenges. So it'll be a surprise for all of us. Now wait a second, do I have to play as Isaac in that one? It looked like it just automatically selected Isaac, it didn't give me a chance to choose a character. Okay, well, I guess Isaac is who you have to play as for this challenge. And you don't start with the D6, as I would if I was playing a normal game with Isaac. So yeah, this will be a brand new experience for all of us. Man, it really bums me out that the chat room's not working. I mean, here I am doing a super special, you know, extra long stream, to make up for not sticking to my schedule, and Twitch just has to go and fuck me. Why you gotta fuck me, Twitch? Oh well. So, I also have to apologize for anyone who follows the Twitter and the Facebook. There was a little confusion about when the stream would actually be starting. Oh, Dazza W, welcome. Oh, well, he left, but hopefully he'll be back. So I realize I have a lot of international viewers, so I try to give times in something universal rather than just going by my own time zone. Because right now, where I am, near the east coast of the United States, it's currently 6:08 p.m. And now my time zone is GMT minus 4, so it's actually 10:09 p.m. in GMT, Greenwich Mean Time. And that's what I posted. It would be starting at 10 o'clock or 2200 GMT. But CPC Gamer got me confused because his time zone, I'm not sure exactly where he lives, but wherever it is GMT plus 1. Which is like British summertime or something. So, you know, he got me a little mixed up with that. No big deal. But there was just a small bit of confusion involving that. Wherever you live, I mean, the internet has really made this, you know, a global... It's a global world, people. It is a worldwide planet that we live in, so learn what your time zone is in terms of Greenwich Mean Time. For example, I'm GMT minus 4. Once daylight saving time is no longer a thing, it'll be GMT minus 5, and CPC Gamer is GMT plus 1. It's a lot easier to talk about it in those terms. Welcome Dazza W and Lord Tamar. Speaking of shit happening, chat's broken. Yeah, I really wish that wasn't the case. Where Tamar says, just started working, it looks like. Hey, Duke. Well, hopefully it starts working for everyone and not just Word Tamar. But I'm glad you're here. The more the merrier. That's what I always say. Because I coined that phrase. I'm a regular Oscar Wilde. Whoa, that's a lot of flies. Jesus. I don't think I've ever seen this challenge room before. I thought it was just going to be the little flies, but then the damn blood flies started showing up. So yes, hopefully at this point, oh, it was only two challenges instead of three? That's really weird. It's like the first two challenges showed up at the same time. Huh. Okay. Anyway, the normal stream time should resume this Tuesday. Every Tuesday and Thursday, and any other day, the mood strikes me. Well, I don't know what I want to talk about with nobody in the chat room. This is unusual for me. This might be a less talkative stream than usual. The Mom's Pearl, I used to have no idea what it did, but I looked it up in the wiki, and it looks like it gives you a greater chance of finding mom items in chests, like mom's lipstick, mom's heels, that kind of stuff. Which is cool, but the rusty key, it makes keys show up more often or something. I'm not exactly sure what the rest of key does. So I still haven't determined what the actual challenge part of this challenge is, other than the fact that you have to play with Isaac and you don't start with the D6. It's like the curse of bad luck or something. So I don't know. Maybe all the pills I find are going to be bad. Maybe none of the slot machines or the shell games I play. Like, I won't win any of them. I don't know what bad luck actually entails. But I guess we'll find out what the effects are, if any. Hopefully the chat will come through. Yeah, hopefully. Do I want the Epic Hack or not? Usually I get it if I don't have good, if I haven't found a lot of stat boosts by the time I find it. Now in this case, I just have normal, you know, plain old Isaac shots, so I'll go ahead and take it. Oh shit, clicked the wrong thing. Okay, tell you what, I'm going to sign in to my Steam friends list. And if anyone wants to send me messages through Steam while I'm playing, since the chat room isn't working, you know, go ahead, add me on Steam. It's, oh shit, that's right, I have the Epic Hack. but yeah, just add Duke of the Bump on Steam, and I will respond to any feedback that you might have, probably. Now the bad thing about the Epic Hack is that it can be kind of difficult to hit some of the enemies, since you have to kind of kite them, so to speak. But of course, you know, the damage is more than worth it. And the other nice thing about the Epic Hack is that it basically gives you unlimited bombs for the purpose of finding secret rooms. So I'm just going to go around bombing walls and see if I can find anything. Just Drop says we're there, it's just not showing our text, and the chat is stuck with something. I didn't see. It's just not showing our text, and the chat is stuck with an infinite loading screen. Well, that's just great. So yeah, I guess for this stream, if you want to communicate, you're going to have to add me on Steam, which is going to be a pain in the ass. I've thought about using an alternate chat service, like Sam SS Skinner used to use. She used to use Mibit. I typed ass and titties like 3 times. Well, it's a shame that that we're missing out on that then. And I'm not going to bother syncing up the chat room, since nobody can chat there anyway. And the people that can chat there, looks like I don't see half the messages. Yeah, the unicorn horn is better than Bob's head, so I'll stick with that. I'm not sure if I've actually showed this off on stream before, but this is one of the new womb rooms. It spawns with, like, I think it's 8 hearts every single time. You have a chance of getting either that or a, I don't really know what it's called. It's like a cathedral room, but it looks slightly different. But yeah, there's one of those on every floor now. Oh shit. Now see, this is going to be a pain in the ass to, oh, never mind. I got him. Now, I don't know if I want to actually try these pills since I have the curse of bad luck. I guess I gotta at least try. Okay, tears up. Well, that's good. Bad trip. That just does damage to you. Not great, but not a, not horrible. Ooh, balls of steel. And another tears up. The tears up doesn't really do anything for me, I don't think, since I have the epic hack, but still. Better than some of the alternatives. Yeah, no keys, so I can't open the item shop. I'm done here. Minkak 1, add me to his or her friends list. And AndyT482, I'm assuming that's CPC Gamer, added me as well. Let me, just approve them real quick. Oh, and K. Lipinov. I hope it's not a problem that I'm showing your Steam names in the stream. There's really no other way to do this. Alright, well, great. That's working out okay. Hold on just one moment and I will continue. I need to, my headphone cable's like wrapped around my microphone and shit. I need to fix some stuff. Is there a chat room feature on Steam? You know, I think there might be. And yeah, that Andy was CPC Gamer. And Kostya, welcome. Can I tell the IRC server once more? Yeah, it is, hold on. It is dukeofthebump.jtvirc.com. And then you have to join # dukeofthebump. But I don't even know if that's working at this point. Honestly, because I could see Just Drop and CPC Gamer, but now they're not, their messages don't seem to be showing up either, so I don't know. Oh, you can invite people to a chat room using the big ass arrow. The chat shows nothing but a GIF called Spinner, even though it's not spinning at all. Great. Just Drop says, if I want, have them add me and I'll invite all newcomers. Okay, so anyone who wants to join the chat room, add Just Drop, J-U-S-T-D-R-O-P, to Steam, and he'll invite you to the big, massive chat room thing. But I mean, you don't have to do that. This is really obnoxious, Twitch. But I guess you are giving me, you know, a server to stream video games on for free, so I can't really complain too much. Alright. We have begun the caves. And I picked up the umbilical cord, even though I'm not really sure I wanted to. It gives you like some kind of special Gemini thing once you once you're down to half a heart worth of health. I haven't actually seen it yet. I only read about it. Damn it! This is one of the enemies that's really annoying to try to kill with the epic hack. Oh cool, it's now a multi-user chat. Excellent. Well, thank you, Just Drop, for organizing this little Steam chat room clusterfuck we have going on. Do I want to check this room out? I don't know. I guess I'm doing okay on health. Mystery pills. Health down, awesome. Mystery pills. Bad guess. Awesome. Okay, that room was totally worth it. That was so awesome. I'm so happy with how that worked out. Plus timestamps if needed, no seconds though. Yeah, the timestamp thing isn't going to work unless it's like specifically formatted for XChat style timestamps. So yeah, no point worrying about that. Ah, oh, damn it! That stupid fly was nowhere near me. God damn it! And Kostya has joined the Steam chat. Welcome. Oh my god. This is so dumb. There we go. I'm going back for a heart here. I need to remember to try all these walls. Oh god. Oh shit. I'm going to take damage here for sure. Okay. Maybe not. Whew. I hate these rooms where the enemies can just entrap you like that. If you're actually— holy shit, look at how fast these things are. Jesus. If you're actually trying for the no damage achievements, those rooms, like the one I was just in, are just the worst. Because, I mean, if I didn't have the epic hack, I probably would have taken damage there, for sure. I wish they'd get rid of daylight savings, it's really not necessary anymore. Yeah, I agree. Navajim says, what was Just Drop Steam? It's the same, Just Drop, JustDrop. Just Drop says, fuck farmers. And, I mean, I don't know if I agree with that, but, I don't think farmers need daylight saving time anymore. It's kind of, an outdated concept. Well, that's pretty good. Mexican968, enter the chat. Yeah, I don't recognize like most of these Steam names, so if I don't know who you are, then you know, introduce yourself or tell me what your normal chat room name is. Oh, BMX. Oh yeah, okay, be a Mexican. You know, that name sounds familiar. Yeah, I knew who you were, CPC Gamer. So, besides Binding of Isaac, I have been playing some games lately. I posted on Twitter that I've been playing too many cute games lately, and I asked for suggestions for a good game for blowing some shit up, and somebody suggested Saints Row the Third, and that's a game that I've been meaning to check out for a while, so I picked it up, and that is a damn good game for blowing some shit up, let me tell you. If you guys want, you can delete me after the stream. I'm too lazy / getting drunk to delete people. Damn. I think I forgot to check the walls in the secret room. Or not the secret room, but the pain room. Oh well. I guess I can check out the item shop. But yeah, Saints Row the Third is fun. I'm a little disappointed because it starts out with like a really, you know, funny, cool bit of story, And I'm about 4 hours into it, and so far, other than the intro, there really hasn't been anything else to the story. It's just been running around doing missions and blowing shit up, which is still awesome, don't get me wrong, but I want more stuff like the beginning of the game. Do the achievements show up in your Wrath of the Lamb game? Yeah, I haven't had any issues with any of the achievements so far. Yeah, sometimes you need to restart Steam for the achievements to show up, but I haven't had any issues other than that. I mean, except for the fact that for some reason I got a different achievement than the candle when I did challenge 1, which hopefully it's just a matter of the meme backwards, and I'll get the candle once I finish this one. How's everything look and sound, by the way? Sounded okay to me, but if there's one thing I've learned, I can never trust my own judgment. Shit. I really should have used the unicorn horn here. I don't know what I was saving it for. Alright, well, that worked out okay. Sounds perfect. Okay, good. It would not allow you to buy the game on Steam. Well, that's weird. Why not? Is it some kind of regional lockout or something? I don't know where the other secret room on this floor is. Apparently there isn't one. Either that or it's in the pain room. Oh, it wouldn't accept your debit card? Oh, that sucks. Yeah, I mean, Steam's pretty good for most things, but yeah, I have heard of people in other regions having those kinds of issues. Curse of Darkness. Well, at least two of them are trapped behind holes there. Blood Bowl crashes my computer and Steam won't accept my key to try to install from it. I guess that's one of the reasons why piracy is still a thing. I mean, it'd be nice if PC games didn't still have these kinds of issues, but they do way more often than they should. The stars take you to yes, the item room. Ooh, technology 2. Now, how does both technology 2 and the Epic Act? That's going to make things interesting. I'm gonna have to be careful not to rely too much on the laser, because if I do, I will totally forget and blow myself out with the Epic Hack. Yeah, hopefully I get the mulligan again. So I'm spawning flies all over the place too. So yeah, I'm about 4 hours into Saints Row 3 and having a lot of fun with that. Or I'm sorry, Saints Row the Third. It's a weird title for a game. But the other game that I've been playing is like the complete opposite of Sifter the Third. And I don't know why I picked this up. I played it like years ago, but I recently got a new Game Boy Advance flash card. Oh, apparently I did unlock the candle. But I didn't get the actual achievement for it. I got the achievement for something else. Well, let's see what it does. Space to use. I haven't actually seen it in action. I've only seen descriptions of it. But I got a new Game Boy Advance flash card. Whoa. Huh. Well, that was pretty neat. And I've been playing this game called Riviera of the Promised Land. It's an RPG. And like I said, I played it years ago and I never bought it. And it is... It's a weird game. It's hard to describe. It's an RPG with a turn-based combat system. And there's no actual exploration. It's almost like a visual novel. You don't actually control your character, you just use menus to like go from one area to the next and navigate the world that way. But it's very story heavy and the combat is very, very grindy. But I've been enjoying it. I've really been craving like a JRPG lately. And that's one of the games that was on the flash cart when I bought it, so I figured I'd give it another chance. Now I had a GBA flash cart before I bought this new one, but it's one of the it requires a special USB linker to use, and the drivers for the linker don't work with Windows 7. So this new one I got just uses a micro SD card, which is a hell of a lot easier than trying to use the linker. I've been playing the game you've called Jesus Christ, you guys, stop giving me so many keys. Hack. Oh, Dungeon Hack. Yeah, that game's awesome. I assume you mean Dungeon Hack. Although, in recent years, I've kind of come to the conclusion that it's not really as good as I remembered. The problem with Dungeon Hack is that it's basically... I mean, you never want to play as any character other than a cleric. There's really no reason to. Which, it's, you know, compared to a lot of other roguelike-style games, you know... like NetHack or something. I enjoy NetHack more than Dungeon Hack because there are a number of different, you know, character types that you can play, and they are all, you know, equally good. So apparently the thing about the candle is that it does damage, but then it recharges very quickly. I don't know if it's worth giving up the unicorn horn for, but I'll hold on to it. Now this is the Forget Me Now. That's the item that I unlocked once I beat the game with, once I beat Sheol with the Blue Baby. And what the Forget Me Now does is it basically undoes the entire level that you're on and starts over with entirely new random rooms and items and everything. But I think I'll leave it alone for the purposes of this playthrough. Have I played Cthulhu Saves the World? Yeah, that game's cool. I played it on the Xbox a while back, but then I got rid of the Xbox. But I also have it on Steam, and I've been meaning to pick it up again. That means you can double dip item rooms. Yeah, that's true, but it also means that, you know, all the enemies will respawn and you have to, you know, kill everything all over again. So I don't know. It's kind of a mixed blessing. Damn. Damn, this technology too and the Ipecac is a pretty cool combo. It's like you get the benefits of the Ipecac, but you can still, you know, hit enemies with precision when you need to. Well, the umbilical cord is really not doing me much good. I think I'll take that. And the matchstick, I think it like spawns more bombs or something. Like it gives you a greater chance of bombs spawning. The rib patch, I think that's good, but I don't remember what exactly it does. I'll take it. What the hell? Aw, man. Stupid greed. Useful if you're doing the no damage run. It resets the damage counter for the first level only. Oh, well, that's pretty cool. I didn't know about that. I don't think I'll ever really make a serious attempt at the no damage runs, except for the basement though. I mean, I might be able to pull off the caves, but there's no way I can do the depths or the womb without taking any damage. Man, that's actually a pretty cool item. I don't know why I didn't get the actual achievement for it, but it's pretty nifty. No, the candle, it actually just recharges automatically. It just takes a couple seconds. So yeah, like someone mentioned, it's like the blue candle from Legend of Zelda. Because there was the red candle, which you had to leave the screen and come back to recharge. And then there's the blue one that you could just use over and over again. Man, I gotta be more careful with this Ipecac. Whoa. Oh yeah, that's what the red patch does. It turns you into some kind of, what's it called? The Doppel. Like the doppelganger. I don't know what actual effect it has on the game. I think it's like better stats or something. Oh yeah, I already have both secret rooms, so I guess there's no point in bombing anything else. Still a lot of bugs in the game. Well, I mean, I think they fixed almost all of them by the 1.2 patch. But yeah, I mean, there are still a couple in here. I mean, this is the kind of game that I imagine it would be really hard to playtest, since everything is so random. I mean, there could be like some weird interaction between two items that you just never see, because in the playtesting, you just never get those two items at the same time. Damn, I was hoping it would be possible to do that without getting hit. Debug screens and spawn commands are your friend. Yeah, but I mean, he would have to sit there and spawn, you know, every single combination of item just to make sure that there's no weird, no weird bugs that happens when you get these two items at the same time. You know what I mean? I mean, there's just so much to this game. Oh! Wow. If anyone has joined recently and is wondering how I'm seeing people talking, the Twitch chat is being obnoxious. So there's a Steam chat room, if you have Steam, that you can join by adding Just Drop, JustDrop, on Steam, and he'll invite you to the Steam party. And thanks, Just Drop, for doing that. That made things better than they could be otherwise. Or if you have me on Steam, just message me, and I'll just invite you to the chat room. All right, well, let's give it the old college try again. So I watched kind of an interesting stream the other night. If you're on Twitter, there's this guy named John Hendren, and his username on Twitter is Fart, and you should add him. He's a funny dude. And last night he was doing a live stream of himself listening to the Disturbed song Down With The Sickness as many times as he could stand in a row, and it was pretty amusing. Well, it was pretty depressing as well. But, I didn't watch the whole time. Supposedly, he streamed the song, 69 times in a row. Because, you know, he wanted to reach a milestone. And the only milestones are, 69 and 420. So, he had to do at least one of those. I mean, I know when I describe it, you know, he sounds like, you know, some juvenile, you know, puerile dude. But he's actually really funny. He writes for Something Awful sometimes, and he's a pretty funny dude. But yeah, that is a terrible song. It's hard to believe that that people get paid, you know, more money than all of us will ever make in our lifetimes combined for touring around the world and playing that abomination of a song. I mean, by the end, you know, I had to stop watching the stream because I just couldn't take it any longer. I don't know how he made it as long as he did. Their other songs are good. That's debatable as well. In my opinion, IMO. Nope. Ooh, contact. That's actually really good. It gives your tears a chance of freezing your enemies. It's kind of like the spider web, where it slows them down, but with this one, it just stops them in their tracks. Really excellent against bosses. We need to do a stupid, uber-difficult challenge stream. Well, what game did you have in mind? I mean, I'm okay with challenges, but I don't know what kind of game we could do. Oh wait, somebody else requested me on Steam. Let me take care of this real quick. There we go. And I'll go on ahead and invite him to the chat room, I guess. There we go. Yeah, Morris Draconis, I don't know where... I don't know where he is this weekend. He had to go to like Tennessee or something. I don't know exactly why, but he's not around. Otherwise, we might have. Oh man, I should have bombed this side just in case there's a secret passage there. Nope. Oh well. So you have to pay attention to little stuff like that. Get the most use out of your bombs as possible. Actually, I think I'll check out the item shop. Console-based stuff that I hate? Like what? Damn, same one. Oh well. I might as well pop some coins in here, into this machine. Steam sale. Yeah, I couldn't afford it, unfortunately. Team Fortress 2 in Minecraft. Well, I don't hate those games. They're just not my cup of tea. I mean, Team Fortress 2, it looks fun, I just don't understand it. I don't understand how it works. And Minecraft, I had a lot of fun with that game for like 6 hours, but I never really saw the point in playing it after that. But I mean, either way, I don't have a console, so it's a moot point. Yeah, the contact lenses are just super, super helpful when you're fighting a boss, as you can see. Alright, well, anything else I want to do here? Nah, I'm done. Minecraft now has an end boss. Interesting. How long do you have to play until you get to that point? Differs, says Namajim. Yeah, I have to be mindful of the fact that that not everyone can see the chat room since I'm not doing the whole chat log thing. I mean, I assume that there's at least some people watching the stream that, you know, don't have Steam, so they can't participate in the chat. But you know, I mean, to those of you who are watching, who I can't see, you know, still thanks for coming. I'm sorry Twitch is being a butthole. I'll come back to the item shop if I get some more money. Well, let's try this. Ah, excellent. I love it when that happens. I got a 2-for-1 out of that bomb. The compass is actually really useful later in the game, so I'll pick it up. Range up, nice. Oh, that's not bad. It's one of the two attack flies you can get. There's distant admiration and forever alone. Yeah, I guess I could go to the arcade. Yeah, I'll hold on to my money. Hi, Monstro. Guess what? You're not going anywhere. Okay, well, maybe you're going some places. I wish the contacts also froze their projectiles. Maybe it just doesn't work on Monstro because his projectiles are so weird. Ooh, the bandage. That's pretty good. It gives you an extra heart and 2 soul hearts. Kostya says, I think Wrath of the Lamb differs from the original because you depend on luck much more often than before. If you don't get a good item, the game is harder. However, if you find a flying item or tech 2, then it's easier. What do you think? I think it's kind of always been like that. I mean, it's a lot. There's a lot more items, so, you know, luck plays more of a factor, I guess, because there are more items that you can get lucky and get. But I mean, they kind of compensate for it's a freaking XL one. They kind of compensate for making it harder by having there be more good items as well. So it's really kind of a trade-off. Man, I hope I find some keys. This is not going to be a very pleasant level if I don't find any keys. Quite a bit of money again. I've only had Technology 1 once since Wrath of the Lamb. Yeah, I haven't found Technology 1 at all since the expansion. I thought they replaced it with Technology 2, but apparently it's still possible to get Tech 1. Oh no. Oh god, no. Oh lord. That could have gone better. I guess I only lost 1 soul heart. I guess I should do a little exploring to try to find some keys before I just head straight for the item rooms. Damn. It's weird that the white flies that just circle the poop still, like, they still count as enemies for the purpose of, like, freezing them. Same with the heads that shoot blood. Oh, wait, shit, there's some people in the chat room now. Welcome, Sirius Kakudemon, Soul Scribe, Tie Dye Tundra, and Zach A112. Is the Twitch chat room fixed? Because that would be very nice. Well, let's see. I'd say this is worth spending 2 bombs to get to. Spend 2 to get 5. It's a pretty good trade-off. And CPC Gamer and Amajim are in the chat room. And Lord Tamar. And oh no, now people are disappearing. No, they're disappearing just as quickly as they arrived. Oh, the humanity. Let's place a bomb here. No, Damn, still no key. And the chat room is back to choking on itself. Oh well, I tried. Hey, now, that's not nice. Maybe it's behind on updates showing people that came, couldn't chat, and left. Yeah, probably. Anyone else have this problem? I don't know. I was watching a stream earlier, and there were only like 3 people in the chat room, but it seemed to be working okay. LordVincent26, welcome. If you're still here. If the chat's working. But, I mean, either way, you know, thanks for watching. Shit! Does the spiderweb also slow down your shots? That's weird. I think it does. Be a Mexican. 968, welcome. J-Man had the problem. Yeah, I was watching Zen Machine Gun stream. And I don't know, seemed to work okay. Oh shit, I didn't mean to actually use the stupid blood machine. Mercuridovich, AlexTF2, welcome, and just drop. I know we were just talking in the Steam chat room, but chat seems to work now, yay! Now see, if I was crazy, what I would do is I would try to get this thing to the fire shot up in this corner so I can get to that chest without having to waste a bomb. So crazy that it actually worked. Spicy Tuna, welcome. Oh yeah, the spider webs also slow you down when you're flying, which I agree, that is silly. But I have a key now, so let's head for the item rooms. Tivanez, welcome. And Kostya, actually in the real chat room now, instead of the Steam chat room. Well, good. It looks like Christmas is going to come after all. I don't like these things at all. I don't like them one bit, and I hope they die. The virus. I think there are 3 different things you can get in a syringe like that. There's the virus, the speedball, and the steroids, I think. Or the growth hormone. And of the 3, the virus is definitely the worst. I mean, it's okay, you know, I'm not going to pass it off, but it's not really anything to write home about. It just makes enemies become poisoned when they touch you. Which I don't really care about because I don't want to be touched in the first place. And the chat room is being dumb again. Droid rage, yeah. Oh, okay. Well, I guess there are 4 syringes then. There's the virus, growth hormone, Roid Rage, and the Speedball. The Speedball is pretty good. It increases both your speed and your own shot speed. And then Growth Hormone and Roid Rage, just like, I think they make you do more damage. And maybe they make you faster. Well, that looks familiar. Homing Ipecac? Darian Mass says he got homing Ipecac in his run. How do you get that? Python4532, welcome. Ipecac plus Bent Spoon. See, I hardly ever get the Bent Spoon. Paradox Zero, welcome. And it's Larry Jr. Jr. Shouldn't be too much of a threat with my contact lens. Welcome, Liquid the Solidus 9000. Glad you can make it. I haven't found a use for my reflection. What about you guys? Well, I mean, it makes your shots, it makes it a little more likely that your shots are actually going to connect, since they come back to you a little bit like a boomerang. Now, ideally, I want to kill this guy's head first, I think. And then if I kill the horse, the body, second, then instead of getting in another cube of meat, I'll get the pony. I'm pretty sure that's how it works. Although I might have it completely backwards. Or there might not be any truth to that rumor at all. Sweet. It's pony. I got a pony. Yeah, I mean, the reflection does kind of suck because it decreases your range slightly, but, I don't know. It's kind of useful. If any of you, another labyrinth? You gotta be kidding me. If any of you are watching for the first time, welcome. Thank you for watching. I stream every Tuesday and Thursday, normally. This is kind of an unusual stream event, since I had to skip Thursday for personal reasons, but, I usually stick to a pretty strict schedule, so, follow me on Twitch. I have a Twitter and a Facebook page, if you want to follow me there. Twitter.com/DukeLPs, Facebook.com/DukeOfBump. There's links in the information down there, and, I will be happy to, have you in the stream, because, the more people in the chat room, the merrier. And normally the chat room works, without any issues. Twitch is just being dumb today. Oh, and, YouTube. I put archives of all my past streams on YouTube. YouTube.com/user/Mashurin. MASHURIN. Is mom still glitched? If you mean the foot like the area of effect on the foot being a lot wider, then yeah, that was fixed in a recent update. It's back to normal now. And, you know, according to his blog, Edmund McMillan still has a lot of changes in the works. So follow edmundm.com. Oh, shit. To see what the new updates are. Aw, man. Oh well, at least I have contacts. Stupid spiky thing. Messing up my plans. Man, I'm a freaking speed demon. I stopped playing Isaac, it's too addictive. Yeah, but it's a good kind of addictive. I mean, it's not like, you know, World of Warcraft or something where you feel like you're obligated to keep playing. You know, that's a great thing about Binding of Isaac, you can play it in short bursts. You don't really have, you know, 8-hour marathon stretches like you do with WoW or Diablo or something. Welcome Turbo2996. Thank you for watching the stream. The stream is made possible by viewers like you. And I wish someone would give me a grant. Like PBS. This shit's educational. I'm teaching you about Bible history. I mean, the story of this game is pretty much straight up, you know, the story of Isaac and the Bible, with almost no changes. Donations are accepted to help Duke keep his apartment fund. Well, I'm not going to lose my apartment. I don't know why you would say that. I'm actually doing, you know, fairly well with my job. I mean, the only thing I would use donations for, if I got them, would be to buy new streaming equipment and video games and stuff to play. Random tears. Eh, why not? Variety is the spice of cliches. But no, I mean, I don't need donations for anything. Oh, what? Excellent. Is Coney even still alive? Yeah, probably. It's hard to tell. But I mean, if he is still alive, he's not really doing anything at the moment. At least that's my understanding. I mean, really, the whole Coney 2012 thing was kind of a kind of a sham, since Joseph Kony hasn't been actively, you know, kidnapping children or anything for years. I don't really know what the point of the sham was, but, I'm a little cynical about that whole movement. Especially considering that the guy behind it was, like, a complete douchebag. Paragot, welcome. Telepills. Man. Python 4532 says, I have a question for all of you. Shoot. I mean, don't shoot. No. I don't want any gun violence in my chat room, but go on ahead and ask her a question. Explosive diarrhea. Well, let's go on ahead and just get rid of that. Sometimes I use the explosive diarrhea to, like, search for secret passages and stuff, but I'm not too terribly worried about it. I'm more worried about accidentally hitting Q and using the pills when I don't mean to. Which is why I prefer to just get rid of them. Damn, look at how fast my tears are. I wish they were always like that. Would you rather have full health and one speed, or full health and one damage, but you could get items? I don't know. They both sound pretty shitty, to be honest. I mean, honestly, I hate being slow more than anything, so I'd probably take the speed. Oh, I have spectral tears. Alright, quick restroom break. I will be back in like 5 seconds. Okay, I'm back. My hands were falling asleep too, because I'm sitting in kind of a weird position. Well, I kind of have to sit in a weird position to stream. Like, I have to set the microphone stand on my keyboard tray. Otherwise, it'll be too far away. And I have to put my keyboard up on my actual desk. So, like, my hands are at a weird angle. But that's what I get for using this top-of-the-line equipment instead of my crappy headset. I like how it freezes their beam as well. When the gluttony dudes get frozen. So like there's just this solid beam of blood just floating in the middle of the room. Even with the Wrath of the Lamb expansion, and even after everything I've seen, I still think these are my least favorite enemies. I cannot get through a room of those enemies without taking damage. I just can't do it. We should do a massive co-op of Realm of the Mad God. Yeah, I've been meaning to check that game out since someone recommended it to me. It looks like fun, but it looks like the kind of game I'd be really bad at. God, look at how fast I am. I'm fucking amazing. Oh, I hate these things. And then Wrath of the Lamb introduced the version of these things with the angel wings, which are even worse. Ugh. All right. For the love of NES, welcome. Man, stupid greed. I swear, like, half the item shops I get are fucking greed. Oh, Jesus Christ. Greed's another one of those enemies that I just can't deal with. I just cannot fight greed without taking damage. I don't know what it is. Something about the way his shots are spread out. I just can't dodge them. Holy shit, look at how much money I have. That's crazy. Now let's at least get myself up to full health. Aw, man. I wasted the bomb. It would have exploded anyway. Check the shops. Oh yeah, there's two shops. Since it's an XL level. Does anyone actually use the charge ability on the pony? I never do. It seems like every time I try to use it, I just end up taking damage. The Emperor. That teleports you straight to the boss chamber. I use the white pony's charge sometimes, though. Yeah, the white pony, it has the Crack the Sky ability, which is actually pretty good. Oh man. This is the remote detonator. You can lay a bomb. Oh yeah, I'm not flying anymore. You can lay a bomb and then hit space to blow it up. And that's all it does. Which I guess is theoretically useful in some situations, but I can't imagine I'm ever going to actually use it. Alright, well, let's look for the other item shop. The white pony is the one I prefer. Well, yeah, I mean, me too, but it doesn't show up until way later in the game. Huh. I was magnetic for some reason. apparently, I mean, I guess it must have something to do with my random tiers. But apparently, one of the tiers that you can get makes you magnetic, because that bomb was being attracted to me. Three Jack Burton, welcome. Range up. Nice. And the soul heart. No, it wasn't a troll bomb, Navajent. I mean, it was a troll bomb, but it wasn't the ones that always comes after you. It was the other, you know, normal kind of troll bomb. And I've noticed that happen other times too. Like, I won't have any kind of magnetic item, but I'll have the $3 bill, and sometimes every now and then it'll be like I have magnetism. I'm not sure what actually causes that. Ultra Kirby 64, welcome. I kind of wish I had spectral tears, because then I could just, you know, chill in the middle of this formation of rocks, and not have to even, you know, come close to being close enough for them to damage me. What did I miss? Not much. I'm attempting challenge number 2, and I tried and failed one time. And this is my second attempt at doing challenge number 2. Bombs are key. No big deal. He's doing good. Well, that's debatable. I'm doing okay in this playthrough. Come on. Did I take damage there? It looks like I took damage. No, this is the whichever challenge is like the bad luck one. Man, I made like 5 new Steam friends today. Awesome. Makes your luck stat as low as it can be. Yeah, I'm still not 100% clear on how exactly the luck stat works. The cursed skull makes it so every time you are hit and you fall to half a heart, you're teleported to the last room you were in. It can be useful. I find it's more obnoxious than anything. What does luck do exactly? I have 4 luck pills in my last playthrough and I didn't see any difference. Navajim says, I don't think anyone does. Yeah, luck is really, I mean, it's really, it's not transparent. Like, it doesn't affect the game in like a super noticeable way, and nobody's really sure how exactly it works. Now, I know that when you play Kane, you start with the lucky foot, and what that does is it makes it so you can't get bad pills, and you have a better chance of winning the slot machine and other games when you're Kane. But I don't know if that's actually the luck stat, or if that's just a separate effect of the lucky foot. What's my Steam name? Yes, just Duke of the Bump. Just as you would expect. Hands 2, welcome to the chat room. Another name I don't recognize. Always nice to see a new face. A metaphorical face. Not your actual face, because that would be kind of creepy. I mean, not that your face is creepy. It would be creepy if I was looking at your face. Because I'm just some random internet dude. Apparently there is only one item shop in the next hill level. Because I've been through this whole map and there is just the one item shop. Unless it's like hidden behind a secret passage or something. Tivenez sent me a Steam invite, so let me approve that real quick. Yeah, if any of you want to add me on Steam, you know, go for it. It's just Duke of the Month. One shop, two item rooms. See, I thought it was supposed to be two of everything. Two item rooms, two bosses, two shops. I guess it would be four secret rooms, since now there are normally two. Do I like ramen noodles? Yeah, they're okay. I mean, it's not the kind of thing I will, eat on a regular basis, but, it's cheap, and, it's somewhat tasty, I guess. I can't eat it too many times in a row, because I get sick of it pretty quickly. My favorite flavor is the quote-unquote oriental kind, which I don't know what it's supposed to actually taste like. Orientals, apparently. But that's kind of, it's not really a PC word nowadays. No, I think it just tastes like soy sauce or something. Today, I ordered a French dip sandwich from a restaurant. And they asked me if I wanted the au jus. And I was like, yeah, I want the au jus. That's what makes it a French dip sandwich. Otherwise, it's just a beef sandwich. I wonder if that's a common request that they get, and that's why they ask. It's like, yes, I'd like a French dip sandwich, but no au jus. Okay, so you want a beef sandwich. Oh, Rob, what's up? Let me accept another request real quick. Wow, a lot of people playing The Binding of Isaac while listening to the stream, apparently. Do a lot of people do that? Just play, but don't actually... Or listen to the stream, but don't actually watch it. But play while they're listening. Because if so, that's kind of cool. I never really thought about that as a... as like a function of the stream before. There are a lot of enemies on the screen. Ah, damn. Shit. I always do that. I get too close to the hands because I'm not paying attention. Well, I charged at her, and I didn't seem to take any damage. Okay, I'm going to be quiet for a minute so I can concentrate. Since I'm getting kind of low on health. Damn. Shit. Wow. That's embarrassing. It's the first time I've been killed by mom in a while. Anyone know what the safety cap does? Yeah, it, I think it makes pills spawn more often. Yeah, increases pill drops. Alright, well, let's, go one more. Give Duke the strength to complete the challenge. Yes. Everyone, please pray to the video game gods for me. Do the Meat Boy challenge. Well, I mean, I kind of like to do them in order. Just for the sake of, you know, neatness. Yeah, the red chest, by the way, is like a normal chest, except that you have a chance of you have a chance of having spiders in it, and you have a chance of getting blue flies from it as well. Well, I guess I might as well go to the item shop since I have 99 keys. I mean, I can't afford to buy anything, but hey, maybe it'll be greed. Damn. Alright, well, if this boss happens to drop 15 cents, then I'll come back for that ladder. Welcome to Minecrafter 1 and the Shock Ninja. And Minecrafter 1 says, this is my first time here. Well, glad you can make it. I think you'll find that this is a kinder, gentler stream than most streams that you find on Twitch. I tend to take a relaxed attitude and, you know, just generally kind of chill and relax. Most people who watch seem to enjoy my chillaxness, my chillaxity. I mean, I take a chillaxative before every stream, so you know I'm plenty chillaxed. Hey, baby, stay away from me. Creepy floaty fetus thing. God, these boss fights take forever when you're at freaking no damage. Like I am, because I'm stupid icy. Duke is to LP what Sigur Rós is to music. Well, that's what I strive for. The only time I've heard Duke rage is Splatterhouse 2. Yeah, we don't speak of that anymore. That's a game that shall not be made, that shall not be named. One of the early LP heroes of YouTube. Well, if by hero you mean I was one of the first people to do it, and yeah. I mean, there's nothing heroic about being the first person or one of the first people to do something. Although I guess I am kind of a pioneer. I mean, when I first started LPing, you know, I could play pretty much any game I wanted and, you know, wouldn't have to worry about there already being an LP of it. But now, There's an LP of freaking everything, man. Any game your heart desires to see, just type it into YouTube and there's going to be an LP of it. Do I like puzzle games? Yeah. I really like puzzle platformers. Go watch my Lost Vikings LP if you haven't already. That's one of my crowning achievements, because I had two awesome people to play the game with, and it made it more entertaining. But yeah, I tend to like puzzle platformers more than just straight up puzzle games. Like, I'm not a huge like Tetris player or anything like that. You know, I like puzzles in the context of a platformer or an adventure game or something like that. Why not play Lost Vikings 2? Well, the problem with Lost Vikings 2 is that it can't be played 3-player, which to me was really, that was the whole appeal of the Lost Vikings LP. I mean, as far as I know, it was the first it was the first 3-player LP of a game like that on the internet. And Lost Vikings 2, you can only play 2-player, and you'd have to you know, you'd have to switch back and forth between characters. Wouldn't be nearly as good, in my opinion. Yeah, no bombs, which is why I couldn't get that X block back there. Have I heard about the game Catherine? I've watched some videos of it. It looks pretty cool. But I don't have an Xbox right now. Wow, Monstro just ate Larry Jr.'s lunch. Thanks, Monstro. Your pal. That's what the tooth did, by the way, if you're confused. The tooth has popped up a couple times on stream, I think, but I just never pick it up because I always have a better item. But I don't have an item right now, so the tooth's the best thing I can get. Yes! Excellent. Holy grail. That is my favorite thing. A puzzle game called Stacking. That's a game I've been meaning to play since I really like Double Fine. But I just haven't gotten around to that one yet. Yes, the Holy Grail gives you it gives you 2 soul hearts and the ability to fly. And also just a regular heart container, I think. Hey, thanks, guys. Damn. I'm still kind of slow, though, unfortunately. Apple Pie Man 2010, welcome. Plants vs. Zombies would be an awesome game for me to try. Yeah, I know Morris has played that one, and he said that he enjoyed it. Oh no, that's one of those, tower defense games, isn't it? Shit. I like tower defense, but I think I might have gotten a little burned out on it. Because I played a ton of the original desktop tower defense flash game. If I can figure out how to get it working with 3 players, would I play Lost Vikings 2? Well, I mean, maybe, but it's not possible. The game doesn't work with 3 players at all, even if you have a multi-tap. Believe me, I mean, me and Moore's and Anaconda Rifle tried to get it working with 3 players, but I mean, unless someone made like a hacked version of the game or something, but I couldn't find anything like that. I mean, I haven't talked to Anaconda Rifle in forever, so even if we did do that, it would have to be me and Morris and somebody else. But I mean, by now, there's plenty of LPs of Lost Vikings 2 out there. I mean, you can go watch, you know, Deceased Crab's LP of it, for all that matters. But I mean, at the time that we did the original Lost Vikings, it was pretty unique. Wow, I have some good items, but my stats suck. My damage and my speed, and my shot speed, they're all terrible. Did anyone watch Deceased Crab's stream that he said he was doing recently? He posted a YouTube video about doing some kind of stream, but it was on livestream.com and not Twitch, which I don't know why, because livestream is terrible. Have I ever played Brutal Legend? No, I haven't. I like Double Fine, but Brutal Legend does not look like the kind of game that would appeal to me at all. I mean, I played the demo, and I enjoyed it. I mean, it was like, it seemed funny and, you know, well-written, and the dialogue and all that was cool. But, the whole aspect of, like, controlling units, and, like, sending units out to do stuff, not the kind of thing I like at all. Welcome to the chat room, Radigan Conniger. Yeah, that sounds right. CPC Gamer says he didn't go to Deceased Crab stream, but he can tell me what I missed. Huzzah! Yes, that is what I missed. The doctor's remote is interesting. I never really used it. I mean, to me, the doctor's remote and Monstro's Tooth both do pretty much the same thing. With the remote, you hit space and it gives you a cursor that you can move around the screen. And from what I heard, you can use the mouse to maneuver. Well, I mean, you can use the mouse instead of the arrow keys if you want, but I heard that you can use the mouse to move the cursor, the reticule, but it didn't really seem to work. Welcome, Evil Zop. It's basically a TD game with Jack Black. Well, tower defense, I guess. Yeah, not my thing. I did really like Trench, though. Trench is kind of a third-person action tower defense kind of game. I played through that with Moors, and I mean, that was a lot of fun. But I don't know if I would want to play that kind of game single player, though. There's three people I steadily follow: Duke, Frankomatic, and Zeta Plays, but Jeff Major has some original games. Yeah, Frankomatic's cool. He does some cool stuff. I haven't watched much of the other two. I rewatched Frankomatic's LP of Mighty Bomb Jack the other day. Because, I don't know, something reminded me of it. And, that's a pretty irritating LP because that game's a nightmare. I actually had Mighty Bomb Jack on the NES when I was a kid, and I never even came close to beating that shit. I mean, I had no idea just how little of that game I actually saw. Gray Words, welcome. Thirty-one people in here tonight. Yeah, see, only 15 are showing up in my list here. So once again, if I haven't said hello to anybody, you know, mea culpa. Well, no, it's not mea culpa. It's Twitch's fault. But no. Splat. You know, Monstrous Tooth isn't bad. I mean, it's definitely better than some items you can get. Just seems like whenever I get it, I always have like, I always have the Book of Revelations or the Elmheart or something like that. Something I just can't give up. Ooh. Pentagram, damage up. Yumheart isn't all that great. Are you crazy? If you get the Yumheart and the nuns have it, then you're pretty much invincible until you get to the womb. I mean, now that the habit is an item in the game, I mean, Maggie is, I mean, she gives Kane a run for his money. As far as, you know, my favorite character is to play. I mean, sure, the habit doesn't show up that often, but yeah, I don't know. It's a pretty common item in item shops. So you are an angel, but you have devil horns. Believe me, you haven't seen the half of the weird-ass shit Isaac can have growing out of his body. I mean, if you think that's weird, wait until, you know, I'm a floating head with a million bugs circling around me and a disembodied brain and a heart dangling from my neck and my eyes bugging out of my skull and a metal coat hanger poking through my head. Well, hi, fellas. You know what? Monstro. Damn. I was hoping I would get a cluster of them. Alright, see you later, Tie-Dye Tundra. Thanks for coming. I think the flat penny really doesn't do me any good. All it does is, it makes golden keys show up more often. Which, I have 98 keys, so that doesn't really do anything for me. Sticky Mouse, what's up? It would be awesome if Duke could play with us. I guess you're still talking about Realm of the Mad God. Yeah, I'll have to try a single player to see if it's the sort of thing I'd be into. But yeah, that might be a possibility. Oh, I'll come back for that if I get really low. Well, shit, I'm dumb. I can just fly to it. And here I was wondering if I should waste a bomb on it. Oh, I'm dumb. My brain is full of dumb disease. You also have 17 bombs. Well, yeah, but it's still not enough. I want 99 bombs. Damn hand falling asleep again. I might have to stretch here in a minute. I actually had a run with a dollar bill and money is power. That's pretty awesome. I've only gotten money is power once. But I had like 40 cents at the time, so. It was pretty cool. I mean, there is an upper limit to the amount of damage that you can deal, though. Which is kind of a bummer. I mean, I understand why they did it that way. But, I mean, it would be nice if you could get to the point where you're just doing so much damage that you can kill anything in one hit. Have I played any of the Fable games? Nope. I've never been interested in that kind of thing. Fable was a lot of promise with no payoff. Yeah, that's my understanding. Oddler, welcome to the chat room. You know, is someone is dumb when they are playing this game and they get Kamaza, and they are on one heart, add use Kamazi, and think Tat will save them. I have no idea what any of that's supposed to mean. We speak English in this chat room, sir. Or ma'am. I mean, I assume that you're talking about Kamikaze. But that's not how any of that... Damn it! Stay away from me, you fucking sin. Sofa Rob, welcome. I had one heart and the Dead Sea Scrolls gave me Kamikaze. Wow, that is some seriously shitty luck. Duke, the rules of greed are if you visited the shop on the previous floor, The shop on the next floor should have greed. Are you serious? Is that actually how it works? Because if so, that is some serious horseshit. I had no idea that there were actually rules to greed. I thought he just randomly showed up from time to time. Well, fuck that. What about the secret rooms? Sometimes greed shows up in the secret rooms too. Are you sure that's accurate, or are you just pulling shit out of your ass? Yeah, because I'm pretty sure that's not true in my experience either. Greedward says, I've gotten to visit several shops in a row, and in one game I got greed in every shop. Yeah, I think you're, ooh. Yes, sorry, Monstrous Tooth. The prayer card is the shit. The wiki suggests the higher the floor level and more money you have, the more likely greed is in a shop or secret room. Yeah, that sounds more accurate to me. What is the white heart? Well, that's an eternal heart. If you collect two of them on a level, then they turn into a full-fledged heart container. And if you leave a level with one, like so, then on the next level, the eternal heart will turn into a regular heart container. And that's how the eternal heart works. Now you know, knowing's half the battle, etc. Holy fuck. Man, I just got my ass kicked. Yeah, sure. I'll take both of these. Fatal Phantom Mace. Welcome to the chat room. The official name of red ones are Max Hearts. Well, that sounds reasonable. Alright, I'm just going to make my way to the item room and then just book it to the boss, I think. Since I have the compass and I know where all that shit is. You know, I realized the other day that there are food items you can get that increase your maximum health. And one of them is like a pet food bowl. And the food bowl has Max written on it. And I thought, well, that's weird. Shouldn't it have Guppy written on it since, you know, Guppy is the name of your cat? But then I realized the reason it says Max is because it increases your max hit points. Kind of a cute little play on words, I thought. Mr. Sergeant 90, welcome. Max is the dog. You can find his head too. Really? I don't believe I've ever seen that. I didn't know he had a dog. I thought it was just the cat, Guppy. Yeah, I knew about Tammy. There's another cat named Tammy, but I didn't know there was a Max's head. Huh. Very interesting. Halo? Not bad. Increases all of your stats by one, including your health. Pretty good. The rotten head grenade is called Max's head. Are you sure? I'm pretty sure it's Bob's head. Because, that's also, That's also the poison bonzi that you can get. Or maybe I'm thinking something completely different. I don't know. The Great M, welcome to the chat room. I hate knights. Bob's head is just a shrunken head. Well, apparently I haven't found Max's head yet. Either that or I just don't remember. Which is quite possible. My memory is not what it used to be. Well, it was never great, but it's even worse than that now. I don't think Bob has ever been explained. Yeah, not really. Oh, Jesus. Oh, my kingdom for technology. Yeah, what the hell? Bombs, you have 30. Yeah, so what? Oh, I mean, I guess I could start looking for secrets now that I have a ton of bombs. I don't know. It's not really worth it. I mean, sometimes you get some good stuff from the secret rooms, but 9 times out of 10, it's just going to be money. Saya-chan and Gambit77, welcome. Knights. It had to be freaking knights. Kinda miss my monster tooth now. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. Oh, use the bombs on the knights. I don't know. It's still kind of a waste. I don't know. I tend to be really stingy with my bombs. Because when I was going through beating Sheol with every character, it's important to save as many bombs as possible for when you fight Satan. Because Satan's very difficult if you don't have bombs. But of course now, that's no longer an issue since I'm doing a challenge run. And I won't have to go to Sheol, you know, to defeat it. The hell are you guys talking about? Electric cars? How did that come up? Yeah, I'm done here. What challenge is this? It's the second one. It's the bad luck challenge, or whatever it's called. I'm not gonna lie, war is kind of a pain in the ass. It's not as bad as death, though. Oh, shit. God, those shots just fire so extremely fast. Haha. Oh, he was stuck in the corner there for a second. I got me a Meat Boy head. Space. Yeah, I mean, I always... Whenever I get the soul card, unless it's early on, or unless I have a lot of soul hearts, I usually just save it for the boss room and use it right before I go to the next level. You know, it's a guaranteed extra heart container. Damn. That is a long way to go to get to the item room. Would I like to ban cars for a better environment? Not really. I mean, I do wish there were more public transportation options available. But I mean, you know, banning cars just really wouldn't be feasible. Especially not in a huge country like the US. I mean, in a smaller country, like a European country or something, it would be more feasible. But yeah, you can't get rid of cars altogether. I mean, I do hate this American idea that like everybody needs to have their own personal car. I mean, in some ways, I wish I lived in a smaller country where public transportation was more feasible, where you can, you know, where you actually have trains. And you can just take the train somewhere instead of having to buy a car and drive it. But I mean, that's kind of the American culture. You know, everybody has to have their own personal car. But I mean, I don't drive, which is why I feel that way. I don't have a car, and I walk or I take the bus. But yeah, I mean, I do wish we had more options. I mean, not necessarily for environmental purposes, although that is important, but I mean, for economic purposes too. I mean, not everybody can afford a car. I know I certainly can't. But you know, I could buy okay. Because I live somewhere where, you know, I can walk or ride the bus anywhere I need to get. But anyone who lives in a more, you know, rural area is going to be out of luck. Galen O'Reilly, welcome. Glad you can make it. If you live in my town, you either have a car or walk a few miles just to get milk. Yeah, and I mean, that's a problem in a lot of areas. I mean, I actually live in one of the few places in West Virginia that getting by without a car is actually possible. But I mean, most of the state is just all totally rural. I hate that word because I can't say it properly. Rural. I always trip up when I try to say that. Shit. Well, Sam, SS Skinner, what's up? Was the Twitch chat room totally freaking out on you, too? Because it has been a pain in the ass ever since I started streaming today. Seems to be okay now, but It was annoying. Sad onion. Sad onion free, just not to three. It's a great item. It makes your shots just so much faster. T-Money 4321, welcome. Yes, it was broken as fuck and it got fixed a bunch after I quit streaming. That sucks. They rebooted the servers. I am excited to see someone do much better than me at this game. Yeah, I'm okay. I mean, I'm still not on the same level as, like, Reign of Sotin or somebody. But, I hold my own. Usually. Although I have died 2 times in the stream so far. Chest within a chest. How Shakespearean. Just been busy with little Babby. Aww. Little Babby. I guess I might as well give this money to someone. If only Fraps could work with this game. Well, I mean, this game is super easy to capture. I mean, any screen capture software is going to work fine for it. I mean, I just use XSplit, which is free. Aw, man. Let's, just out of curiosity, see if I can get it out of here. Well, nope. Okay. Oh, well. I'll go back for some hearts if I need to. I'm doing okay right now, though. Also, chest within a chest would be a Poe reference. If you're referencing the dream within a dream. No, actually, I was referencing Hamlet. Because it's like a play within a play. I don't know. I don't really know if it was appropriate, but that's what came to my mind. Evil Pancake, welcome. Damn it. Is it just me or has mom been spawning more shit than she usually does? Seems like the last time I fought her too. She was just spawning way more shit than usual. Maybe they changed something in the update or something. Or maybe it just seems like it because I don't have the broken shit that I usually have. Like the mulligan spawning a billion flies everywhere. Damn. Alright, I'm definitely gonna have to go back for some hearts. Oh yeah, I can. Isaac. Fuck. Was cornered. Oh well. His mother, wait, fueled with the desire to serve her god, was bearing down on Isaac. I will do as I'm told, my lord. I love you above all else, Isaac's mother repeated to herself. This was the end of the line for Isaac. His mother was far too strong for him. But just as he accepted his fate, God intervened, sending an angel down from above to stop his mother's hand. And just like that, it was over. Okay, well, apparently when you're doing a challenge, you don't even have to do the womb. It just ends at mom. Darian Mass says, the first couple of challenges end at mom. What do I mean by challenges? With Wrath of the Lamb, I can't skip this. With Wrath of the Lamb, there are 10 challenges that you can do, and they each basically play through the game with a different effect. And I was just doing the second challenge. Welcome, Gary Dempsey. You have to do Sheol in one of them. I imagine it gets harder as you go on. Alright, well, that was fun. Let's do another one. Why not? Yeah, 7 years of bad luck. That was the challenge that I just did. And I already did Dark with the Night. So let's see what Large Marge is all about. According to what someone in the chat room said... Damn, you still have to play as Isaac? I hope that's not the case for all the challenges. I want to be Kane, damn it. Someone in the chat room said that every level is going to be the Curse of the Labyrinth. So it's going to be Basement XL, or in this case, Cellar. Followed by Caves XL, and then the Depths or Necropolis XL. So yeah, should be a good time. I don't know if you have to do the womb in this one or not. Usunuro, welcome. And Private Steve, welcome. Any chance for a pop-up stream any day? Yes, someday. I don't know what day, but someday. Darian Mass says this one ends in mom as well. So, shouldn't be too long. My achievement on Steam didn't pop up, so I'm probably going to have to close it and then restart it to see if I actually got the candle or not. Because for anyone just joining, when you beat the first challenge, it's supposed to unlock the candle, which apparently it did, because I was able to buy the candle, but I didn't get the achievement for it. I got the achievement for number two. So I'm hoping that when I beat number two, it gives me the candle achievement. Because otherwise, then I don't know how I'm going to get it. I mean, not that achievements actually matter, but, you know, it would be nice to be rewarded for my efforts. This stream may be extended. I'm doing an extra hour or so since I didn't get a chance to stream on Thursday. Cause why not? I know, as soon as I walk over there, the spider's gonna jump into my face. Nyu, welcome to the chat room. Alright, stupid. Goddamn spider. I'm gonna have to be tricky about this, aren't I? Because Duke cares about our happiness. Yes, that's right. I care about the happiness of each and every one of you. Super Sloth. Super Sloth spits spiders. And he vomits uncontrollably. Two at a time. Damn. His range on those spiders is impressive. Ah, damn. This is actually somewhat of a challenge, unlike normal sloth. He's generating a lot of spiders, and he's tough. He has quite a bit of health. And I don't have any items at the moment, so I'm flying blind here. Ultra Crowder and Derek Sharna, welcome to the chat room. The Joker automatically teleports you to the Devil Room or the Angel Room. So the reason I went on ahead and did that is just in case it was an Angel Room, but it's not. Aw, man, now I have to go all the way back there to get that pill. Oh yeah. They're telling me in the chat room that I should have gotten the shovel, but I'm not a fan of giving up hearts for anything. I mean, the shovel's pretty good, but I would rather not have to give up the health. This isn't a long challenge. Shovel would actually gimp you. Yeah, I mean, that's a good point. The shovel, for anyone who doesn't know, it digs through the floor that you're currently on and automatically takes you to the next floor. Which is good, except that you miss whatever items you would have found on those floors. So, that is my rationale for passing it up. What is it about these spiders that they just sit there until I move in position for them to just fuck my shit up? I don't like them. That's plain dirty. Oxbow told me about you, watched the one with Oregon Trail, learned a lot about Isaac that night too, so thank you. Oh, you're welcome. I'll have to thank Oxbow for spreading the word. I would like to do another Oregon Trail stream at some point, since I had a lot of fun with that. I should do another one and see if I can beat my score. I mean, Oregon Trail is fairly randomized as far as, you know, the events that occur. So it would be kind of like Isaac in that it's a little different every time. So many ghost hearts. Yeah. Well, when I was playing as the Blue Baby only has ghost hearts. He doesn't have regular hearts. And when I finally beat Sheol with them, I had like 16 soul hearts or something. It was insane. I had like 4 more than could actually fit on the screen. Of course, that's highly unusual luck. I want to hold on to my keys because when you have the Curse of the Labyrinth, normally the first item room you encounter is unlocked. But with the Curse of the Labyrinth, both of them on the first floor are locked, which is kind of shady. So I'll hold on to my keys for now. I don't have any money anyway, so there wouldn't have been any point in going in there. Book of Revelations plus battery plus 9-volt plus habit equals invulnerable. Yeah, I mean, really, all you really need is the Book of Revelations and the habit. I mean, until you hit the womb. But in normal circumstances, just that would be enough to keep you alive pretty much forever. You know what? I think I will use a bomb. Just to make things a little bit easier on myself. You know what I just realized? I'm probably going to have to fight Widow. Because it's the cellar, and there's 2 bosses in the cellar. So, I mean, at least one of them is pretty much guaranteed to be the Widow. Or just a Widow, not the Widow. She's a tough boss to deal with early in the game. Well, I don't have any other items, so I might as well hold on to it for now. Sergeant Trek, welcome. There's two cellar bosses, Pin and Widow. Well, yeah, but, I mean, there might be, you know, it might be nice and give me a basement boss instead. A lot of times I see, not a basement boss per se, because, you know, they can show up in other places. But sometimes I see the Duke of Flies as a boss in the cellar. Man, the bean. All it does is that when you hit space. Two pretty terrible items to get right off the bat. I guess I'll hold on to the cookbook. It is the better of two evils at this point. I think you only encounter cellar bosses in the cellar. Nope, I've definitely fought the Duke of Flies in the cellar before. Yeah, fuck it. Yep, there he is, Duke of Flies. Anarchist Cookbook isn't bad. Yeah, but I always end up fucking myself and hitting myself with a bomb whenever I use it. I am very surprised it didn't happen just now. Well, hopefully, honestly, I probably should have saved the Anarchist Cookbook just in case the next boss is the Widow. Hopefully it'll be Pin or something. Damn. Almost backed myself into a corner. I'm glad I could get out of that. Ah, damn. Just got a little bit too close to that fly. Rotten meat. Yum. Duke of Flies can be a pain on the first floor. I don't have too many issues with them. Alright, please don't be Widow. Sweet. It's just Pin. Finally, a little bit of luck. I really wish it didn't make you play as Isaac for these challenges, though. But I guess that's what makes it a challenge. You don't get any of the awesome starting stuff that you would get for being Cain or Magdalene. And you don't even get the D6, even though you are Isaac. So I guess that's part of it. Woo! That's close. Alright. Same stuff as before, right? Yeah, same stuff. F it. There's a poll on the wiki. Which is your favorite character? Cain was first, Isaac was second. Yeah, I would say Magdalene is my second favorite character. Cain is still first, obviously. Unless Isaac has the D6. And in that case, Isaac is my second favorite. Welcome, Funesh. Judas is my favorite? Sir, you're fucking crazy. Judas is not a good character. I mean, if you can manage to survive the first few floors, then yeah, he can be pretty good. But his starting health are just so low. I would never play with him. Well, I mean, except to get the achievements for beating the game with him. But I would never use him voluntarily. Fezzes are cool. Well, I guess I can't argue with that logic. First floors are easy, he destroys all. Yeah, unless you get hit twice. Which, I don't know about you, but I'm not 100% confident of my abilities to beat a level without getting hit twice. But maybe I just suck. Maybe Judas is good if you don't suck, and that's my problem. Damn. Oh my god. Such a clusterfuck in this room, man. Actually, in that poll, Judas was third. Huh? Apparently... excuse me. Apparently that's an unpopular opinion then. Are you just going to sit there all day, stupid? Are you really going to do this to me? God damn it. Where was Samson? Hopefully at the very end of the poll. The bottom of the poll. Because Samson is the worst character. I would rather use Judas than Samson. The blue baby is the worst character, but he's a joke character. Nobody's actually supposed to play with the blue baby. But other than him, Samson is just the worst. The blue baby beat Samson in the poll. That's hilarious. Good for him. Welcome to the chat, AMC Gal. Lots of new faces. I love it. And by faces, I mean anonymous internet chat room handles. The Hierophant. Soul Hearts, I think. Yep. Excellent. I don't get that liking Eve more than Samson. Well, Eve's pretty awful, too. I mean, really, all the characters are bad. Except for, Cain, Magdalene, and Isaac with the D6. Are you going to do this again? Making me step into your line of fire. Asshole. Maggie sucks. I disagree. I mean, Maggie's not fun to play as because her starting speed and stuff is so low. But as far as survival goes, she's probably the best character. I mean, your chances... I mean, the first time I ever beat the game, it was with Maggie. I mean, having that yum heart just increases, and the extra starting heart, it just increases your chances so much. But I still prefer Cain, because I prefer his starting stats over hers, and the ability to only get pills is pretty good, to only get good pills is pretty good. I don't know if this will work or not, but it's worth a shot. Nope, didn't work. I was hoping I would catch at least one of them while they were popped up. You know, you guys can die any day now. Any day now. Thank you. Jesus Christ. Please be something better than the last floor. Okay. I'll take it. What a crappy room that was. Yeah. That room was terrible. Horror of Babylon is always on for the blue baby. Yeah, I guess that's one thing he has going for him. If you can get that item. The other item on this floor is Tech 1. Well, that would be pretty awesome if it worked out that way. Of course, you jinxed it, so now it's not going to happen. H.C. Bailey is starting a Final Fantasy XII LP. Wow. That, I'm not gonna lie, that sounds really boring. But I didn't like Final Fantasy XII, and I don't like LPs of RPGs, usually. I enjoy them sometimes, if it's a game I really like. Or if the commentary is especially good. 12 is certainly a game, says Namajin. Indeed. That is a piece of software for the PlayStation 2. Maybe I should use my cookbook here. Nah, that's a bad idea. With them chasing me around, I'll run into one of my bombs for sure. There we go. That worked out. Technology 2 sets damage to 1. Yeah, that's true, but my damage already wasn't great, so it's not a downgrade for me. God, another one of these? Really? Oh well. At least I have technology now, so it's a little easier to get through this. I'm not sure if this stacks with technology or not. No, I don't think so. I think it's a shot speed increase, which doesn't matter. Oh well. The game is not being friendly to me. No, not really. Man, there are a lot of hearts scattered around. I'll go ahead and fight the boss, and I'll go back for some of them if I need to. Well, I'm not gonna lie, that could have gone better. Hey, you're supposed to eat the bomb, Chad. Apparently Chad doesn't do that. Just chub. Alright, let's go back for some of those nice pretty hearts before I continue. Try and find another key for the library. Yeah, that might be a good idea. I can go use this slot machine over here. Psychic Psych, welcome. Glad you could come. Chad doesn't eat bombs. Well, why not? He should. They're so... Oh, it's not a slot machine. It's this dude. Okay, well, let's see if you have a key for me. Well, that's pretty good. In fact, I'll go on ahead and use that. Double my money. Well, it's not a key, but it was still worth it, in my opinion. There's an item where a beggar follows you. Yeah, the bum friend. I'm not a big fan of him. He collects coins on your behalf, and occasionally he'll spit out an item for you. But so far, I haven't really gotten anything useful. I'd rather just have the coins to begin with. But I mean, occasionally there will be a coin that you can't get to, like behind a pit or something, and he's useful in that case. Hey, awesome, thank you. How about another one? Well, that is still pretty good. I will not complain. Alright, let's poke around a little bit more and see if I can get one more key. So I can go to both the item shop and the library. I mean, I would say the library takes precedence over the item shop. Because, you know, I can get a free item. Nah. I'll take the Book of Shadows. It gives you a shield that lasts about 10 seconds or so. Which isn't bad. Yeah, and sometimes you'll get non-book items in the library, but not in this case. Alright, see you later, Katja. Aw, man. I don't like Gertie. Alright, well, let's go ahead and take care of these while I'm invincible. What the? Oh. I didn't even see that fly there. I thought I killed all the flies. Having technology does make this fight way easier, though. Well, having technology makes most fights way easier. But Gertie's, you know, it's especially good against Gertie. Because you can take out the flies and stuff while still doing damage to Gertie. I appear to have thrown him for a loop. Excellent. What's up, Perp? I'd say that worked out pretty well. Not responding. Oh, there it goes. That was weird. Never had this game crash on me before. I'd be kind of pissed if it did crash on me because it's just a flash program. Ah, shit. I never get greed. I always get super greed. Wow. I am very sorry for you. Because, I mean, greed's bad enough as it is. No, the book recharges pretty quickly. The Book of Shadows. That's one positive. Oh no. Oh, these rooms are a fucking nightmare when you're not flying. Die, please. Please die. Thank you. You die too, please. Thank you. Well, that could have gone better. Oh, shit. Stay away from me. God damn it. I tried to take out the eggs as quickly as possible, but it did not go well for me. Oh, good lord. Man, I am getting some tough rooms tonight. Tough crowd. Poison bombs. Eh, that's okay. Welcome, Yemo92. Hopefully some plus damage on this floor before the bosses. Yeah, that would be pretty nice. Oh no. I want to fucking die. Yeah, the Book of Shadow charges after three rooms. Oh, Lord. I saw that one coming. Alright, well, I guess that'll about do it for tonight. Well, at least I got one victory in. Better than it could have gone. But thank you everyone who came to the chat room. Thank you for everyone who was watching the stream who wasn't in the chat room. If you don't mind, please follow me on Twitch if you don't care. I'm also on Twitter and Facebook if you want to follow me there. You don't have to, you know. If you use those, then, you know, at your discretion, I would appreciate it. I thought you were going to go an extra hour. Well, I've been playing since 6, so I have been going for an extra hour. I mean, this will make 3 hours. God, you people are so ungrateful. Everything I do for you. No, I'm just kidding. Alright, well, next stream on Tuesday. So, I will see you then. And, I love you all. Goodbye.